Hello guys, welcome to 5mantra.com. This is Kalyan, the faculty of aptitude. Okay, we are going to discuss now about some different technique of mensuration. Okay, let us see what it is. It is a technique of cylindrical rods. Again, four rods are tied together. Okay, when four rods of cylindrical shape are tied together with a rope tightly, then what is the length of rope is required for tying them? Okay, if you did not understand this, I want to show you the experimentally. So look at this, guys. Okay, what I explained to you in about the cylindrical pipes which are tied, that I'm going to show you experimentally. So this is that. Okay, is this or this batteries? This batteries are of cylindrical in shape or not? These are cylindrical in shape. Okay, now this rope is tied. These are tied with this rope along their curved cross sections. Okay, curved surfaces. Now this rope is tied like this. Okay, and misconception with the students is they feel that it's the rope tied. Means shape of the rope is a circle. Is it a circle? That's a misconception. It is not in the shape of circle. See here. Is it straightened here or not? Just look at this. I want to show you. So here is it straightened here or not? It is straightened. And here it is curved. And here it is. Here it is again straightened. And here it is curved. Here it is straightened. And here it is curved. And it is straightened. That means it's not completely curvilinear in the nature or not completely straightened in the nature. So somewhere it is straightened. Now if you observe the front section of this front section, this front section seems to you like what? Is it a circle or not? How many circles? Four circles are attached or not? Four circles are attached. Okay, in such a way that each touches another two, each touches another two, each touches another two. And here one more thing, once again I am clarifying, is this rope tied is neither in the shape of circle nor in the shape of square. For suppose if you want to feel this as a square, then this should be, there should have vertices. Is there any vertex? No, because this is here curved. This is here curved. See, this is here curved and here also curved. So there is no formation of vertices. So clear for you guys that it's neither in the shape of square nor in the shape of circle. Here straightened, curved, straightened, curved, straightened, curved, straightened, curved. So it's not described. This rope is not describing circle or not describing square. Clear for you or not? Let us move on to the problem. Now, let us look at this, guys. Till now, what I have shown you experimentally, that I'm going to draw the diagrammatic part of that. Okay, let us draw the diagram or the front section which I have shown you. Okay. What is the front section of that? Let us draw this. See, front section of that is showing circles or not? Okay, total four circles are tied with a rope. In that shape it is there or not? Even though those are three-dimensional shapes, but to analyze the length of the rope, only front portion of that is required. Means base portion of the cylindrical rods that are circles. Okay, all the bases are equal. That means all the radius of the circles are also equal. Now let us draw the figure, rough diagram for that, and let us do analyze. Now see this, guys. Is this a shape of the front section of the four rods or not? Cylindrical rods. And as we mentioned that they're having the equal radius. So here this radius and this radius and all the radii are equal. Okay, now let us tie this with the rope.
how we have to tie it. Means, let us take the lines. Now, how we have seen in those batteries, means in that explanation part, okay, in experimentally, that I am doing here, okay. Now, isn't it the shape? Now, exactly what we have observed in that observation which I have shown you in the batteries, is it same as that or not? Okay, is it looking like that or not? Same thing we are doing here again. So now, let us find out the total length of this rope. Is this a length of rope or not? This is the total length of rope, okay? So now, how to find out the total length? So, as I said you, this shape is not a square, not a circle. So, when it is not defining any shape which is known to us from the basics of mensuration, then how to find out the total length? Means, for this diagram, we need to find out total perimeter. How to find it out? There are no relevant formulae. For finding out, what we have to do here is, we need to analyze the shape by separating, that means partitioning the shape into different parts. How to partition them? Okay, by plotting the radii. Okay, by plotting the radius, we can do this. And let us do this and observe. Let us suppose it's a center of this circle, and we plot a line like this. Is it a radius or not? Guys, is this a radius or not? Now, again, if this is a center, is this again one more radius or not? Radius of this circle. Now, if you plot here, is this a radius again or not? This is one more radius. And if you take one more radius from here also for this circle, this is the combination of two radii or not? It's a combination of two radii again. So, what is this figure formed here? In order to know that, I want to remind you one property of geometry. What is that property? Let me tell you. Okay, see here. If this is one circle and this is a line drawn which is touching that, and this line is called tangent of the circle. When it's a tangent of circle, it is touching at some point or not. This touching point is called point of contact. From that point of contact, if you draw the radius to the circle, that will be perpendicular to the tangent. And technically, this radius is known as normal. Same as that, you have drawn here one radius, and this length of the rope, here this rope is acting as a, see, if you continue this like this, it's a line or not? So, it's a line, and this is a tangent, rope is behaving as a tangent or not? Now, when it's a tangent, with this tangent, this normal will make how much angle? 90 degrees or not? So, this will make here 90 degrees, okay. So, it's making here how much angle? 90 degrees. So, here also it will make 90 degrees of angle, okay. Clear for you or not? So, it's clear. So, here it is making 90 degrees angle. So, here this is 90 and this is 90 and this is 90 and this is 90. So, what is this figure representing? Here, these all are 90 degrees, and what are the radii? Let us represent them. Here, is this a radius or not? And is this a radius or not? These all are radii. And here, adjacent sides are not equal. Why? Because this is 2r in length and this is r in length. So, adjacent sides are unequal for this quadrilateral, and all the angles are 90s. So, definitely what shape does it represent? Okay, this is rectangle. When it's a rectangle, opposite sides are equal. So, equal in the sense, this length is 2r. So, opposite length also will be 2r. So, obviously here, this length will be how much? So, this length will be 2r. Okay, in the same way, if you analyze for the remaining circles also, what do we get? Here also this is 2r, this is 2r, this is 2r, likewise or not? Okay, let us see what it is. So now this again is, this is also all are partitioned same as that. Now all the lengths are. And here also 2R. And here also it's 2R. So what is separated? Now this length is 2R and this length is 2R and this length is 2R and this length is 2R. So what happened is here we could find this part and this part and this part. So all this part's lengths are fine. Okay, so here this is 2R, this is 2R, this is 2R and this is 2R. But still, there, as we divided into pieces, 4 pieces we could find here. Okay, now we have to find out this part also or not. See, observe this part also. Like that, how many parts are there? This one and this one. What is it? Arc or not? Can we find the length of arc or not? Obviously. What does this shape represent to? So this is it looks like this or not? So is it a sector? Obviously it's a sector. And what is the angle of sector then? Then we have to find out the angle of sector. For that we do, let us do small analysis. Just see here. See this guys. Here, tell me, is this a rectangle or not? This is a rectangle, this is a rectangle. So obviously this angle would be how much? 90. And this is also 90. When it is making 90 degrees, and this is also rectangle or not? So this is also 90 degrees. Means this is also rectangle, here 90. Since it's a rectangle, this is also 90. So here this is a square or not? Why? Because here all are R's only. So of every side of this inner quadrilateral, this quadrilateral is representing, okay, square. Why? Because here every side is equal to 2R. So this is 2R, this is 2R and this is 2R. When all are 2R's, okay, this is a square. So again angle is 90. So if you observe carefully, this angle is 90 and this angle is 90 and this angle is 90. So what is still left? This one only, no. So out of 360, 270 degrees is over. This is 90, 180 and 270. So what is still left? Again, this angle also would be 90 or not. So what is the angle of sector given? 90 degrees. Clear? Angle of the sector is 90 degrees. Why we find the angle? Because we need to find out the length of this arc. And length of arc would be, formula is, okay, theta by 360 degrees times of 2 pi r. Theta is angle made at the center of sector, which is 90, representing in all the cases. Okay, for all the cases, it is how much? 90 degrees. Here also this is 90, and here also this is 90, and here also this is 90. Means all the sector angles are equal to 90 degrees. Well, and radius of each sector would be capital R. So what can we find here, dear students? Here we can find out the length of arc, isn't it? Now let us do. Now have a look at this guys. Each sector angle is 90 and radius is R, capital R. Then what would be your area of each sector? See, tell me, what is the area of each sector guys? Here 90 degrees angle by 360 into 2 pi and radius of each circle would be capital R. Okay, now if you cut with 90, 94 times. Is that right or not? Now with 2 we can cancel. That would be how much? Pi R by 2. So each sector, okay, each sector area would be how much? Not area, each sector, length of arc of each sector would be how much? Pi R by 2. And let me know that how many such a sectors are existing over there. This and this and this and this. That means four sectors of equal angles each 90 degrees and each radius capital R is there. Four sectors are equal. So we can multiply this with 4 to get the total, this part of curved length, this part of the curved length, this length of arc, this length of arc, this length of arc, and this length of arc. So to find out the total length of all the arcs, okay, is how, what we have to do then? This pi r by 2 should be multiplied, pi r by 2 should be multiplied with 4, because 4 times of that would be total lengths of these all. So when you cancel this with 2, that would be 2 pi r again or not? So total length of all the lines covered part, the length of arcs is how much? 2 pi r. So let us do a final answer for this. So now let us see here, whenever we have given this type of figure, so here what we got now, tell me, we partitioned this diagram and we find the length of the rope piecewise, because we can't find it directly. So here when we are finding like this, so this is 2r, this is 2r, how many switches, such a 2r's are existing over there? This is 1 2r, this is 1 2r, this is another 2r, this is a, so 2r is repeated for how many times? 4 times. So total lengths of this part and this part, so this, these two parts and these two parts would be how many parts? 4 times of 2r, each is 2r, so 2r is repeated for 4 times, then we could cover this length, this length, this length, and this length. Now what is still left? Now only we said that this part and this part and this part and this part, the total length of the curve or total length of the arc for this and this and this, we find as how much? 2 pi r. So what is your answer for finding this? Finally, it can be written as, this is 4 into 2, 8 r, 4 into 2 how much? 8 r, and here what is that? 2 pi r, 8r plus 2 pi r. So did we get this or not? So what is the length of total rope? I mean total length of the rope. This total rope length is, how much is that? 8r plus 2 pi r. Got it or not? Now again, whenever you have given some problem based on this, do we need to do this total analysis, or just we can substitute the value of r within that? Simply we can substitute the value of r within this formula and we can get the answer. Is that right or not? Here simply, if suppose we have given that each cylindrical rod of base radius 4 centimeters is given, and you need to find out the length of the rope to tie the entire 4 rods tightly, then what is your answer? Don't need to bother about this entire process. Only you have to do only one thing, and what it is? Just simply substitute the value of radius 4 centimeters here and you get the answer. So friends, this is a use of analysis. If you do analyze the figure in the beginning itself, then it will become so easier for you to do tackle such kind of problems whenever you will be given an exercise on that. Okay, so we don't need to do this entire process while doing the problem. We just have to substitute the value of r in this obtained pattern, and then we can finally get the answer. Is this technique is worthy or not? So guys, if you would have liked this video, then please don't forget to subscribe this channel. We will give you a lot of valid content like this. So many videos are there from mensuration and geometry, especially which are useful for CGL and CHSL, means Staff Selection Commission notifications. We are going to give you the videos on wide range. And one more thing, I'm going to provide the exercise on this, okay, in our next video, and do that. And try to understand. Thank you.